Bitcoin is a new kind of digital currency. Just like any other currency in the world, you can buy things with it, send it to other people, or just store it for future use. However, unlike most other currencies, Bitcoin has no physical form. Instead, anything you do using Bitcoin is done over the internet. That's really the gist of Bitcoin. You can still buy stuff with it, or store it, or send it just like any other currency. Just all that is done online. Bitcoin was created to simplify not just online payments, but also currency in general, and it accomplishes that through a very unique and kind of genius method of operation. Bitcoin is a completely open system. Every Bitcoin transaction is public and is added to a gigantic public list of records, which is called the blockchain. When you send Bitcoin to someone else or receive Bitcoin from someone else, that transaction is processed by the Bitcoin network, which is a network of computers that connects the sender to the receiver and makes sure that the transaction is processed correctly. The Bitcoin network is also open. If you want to add your computer to the Bitcoin network, you can do so by simply downloading some software and letting your computer start crunching the numbers of various transactions in a process called mining. In exchange for letting the Bitcoin network borrow your processing power, you actually obtain free Bitcoin as well. You should also know that there are other digital currencies or cryptocurrencies besides Bitcoin. There's Ethereum, Litecoin, and Dogecoin, just to name a few. But really, you should only be paying attention to Bitcoin. Bitcoin is the most popular and established cryptocurrency, and its exchange rate is somewhat predictable, making it a better exploration than any other cryptocurrency. Now let's jump back to Bitcoin mining. Like I mentioned earlier, mining is basically lending your computer's processing power to the Bitcoin network in exchange for free Bitcoin. See, the role of Bitcoin miners in the Bitcoin network is twofold. First, miners verify transactions and add them to the blockchain, and two, they attempt to solve computationally difficult puzzles to create new Bitcoins. Therefore, the more powerful your computer's GPU and CPU is, the more efficiently you'll be able to mine Bitcoin. So that's all well and good, but really, what's the point of using Bitcoin at all? Why not just pay for things with a credit card or cash like a normal person? Well, because Bitcoin is decentralized, there's no central authority that can limit what you can do with it. No one can block access to your money, it's completely free to use Bitcoin, and for businesses, it means you can start accepting Bitcoin without having to fill out loads of paperwork or pay a bunch of fees like traditional payment networks. Bitcoin is a big deal. Already, it's drastically changed the way the world of finance operates, and it's making us rethink our idea of what money even is. A single Bitcoin right now is worth a little more than $4,000, and I guess you could say that's a testament to the fact that Bitcoin is here and is probably not going to stop shaping finance for a long time. Please subscribe to Arium TV for more thought-provoking awesomeness, and I will catch you guys in the next video.